What's up, everybody? Ghostly Whispers here, back with a brand new video, and today we are going to be talking about one of my most favorite television shows and films of all time, as far as sci-fi is concerned, and that is Star Trek. Yes, I said Star Trek. Who's out there? We like Star Trek, dude. But before we get into that, make sure you click the subscribe button and the notification tab for more great content, alright? Because if you don't, I will personally appear in your bathroom window. Your bathroom mirror, in other words. Every time you go to the bathroom, you just say, Ghostly Whispers. Times and I will appear. Alright, just kidding. Let's get on with the video. You know, as far as Star Trek is concerned, it is really ironic because the creator, Gene Roddenberry, when he first pitched idea of Star Trek, he pitched the idea to every major television studio in Hollywood, and nobody bought it. Nobody was interested in the idea. Nobody was interested in the project. Everybody thought it was silly. Everybody thought that it was stupid. Now, I really can't quite remember what studio decided to take a chance on it. I can't remember which one, but one particular studio did. And that was the best decision they've ever made. Even though the television show was a success, but it really took off when the show hit syndication. Even more fans, millions of fans, actually. That's when Star Trek actually really took off. I mean, it was successful during the show, but it was even more successful when the show took off during syndication. When the show was canceled off television, the fans, they pretty much lost their minds. I was one of them. The fans wasn't really quite ready to let Star Trek go. The fans wanted more Star Trek. They demanded more Star Trek. And later on down the line, when the fans learned that there was going to be a new and improved Star Trek, it was really more of a catch-22. And the reason why I said that is because the fans was quite disappointed that the original cast and crew and the Enterprise was not going to be part of the equation, but a new and improved Star Trek, a new cast, a new crew and all that. So I guess the fans was like, you know what, a new Star Trek is better than no Star Trek at all. So it was a bunch of mixed feelings about it, but the fans was still excited nonetheless. And next thing you know, Star Trek The Next Generation was born. Now, I have to be honest with you, I was kind of skeptical of myself because at first I thought the new Enterprise was ugly. And, you know, and they had a new captain who played the part of Captain Jean-Luc Picard, who was Patrick Stewart, and at first I really didn't know what to think about the idea, considering the fact that, you know, he was British, and I really didn't know that much about Patrick Stewart. That was the first time I actually saw him. I mean, he has a long acting career, but he spent the majority of his acting doing theater. But that was the first time that I actually knew who he was. And at first, I wasn't really quite sure. Not saying that he couldn't play the part, but I wasn't really quite sure. Captain Jean-Luc Picard was a complete and totally different ball of wax than Patrick Stewart. I mean, Captain Kirk, Captain James T. Kirk of the original Enterprise, they were completely two different people. Jean-Luc Picard was very stern, no nonsense, always played by the book, very strict. He wasn't a whore like Kirk was. I mean, Kirk slept with anything that moved, but Picard wasn't like that. I mean, he had several love interests during the show's run, you know, The Next Generation, but he had an on-again, off-again relationship with Beverly Crusher. We'll get to her in just a second. And then there was Will, Commander Will Riker, Picard's first officer. He was a great character. I really enjoyed his character, you know. He had quite a few love interests on the show itself, but his main squeeze was Deanna Troi, Counselor Deanna Troi. We'll get her in just a second. As far as Will Riker is concerned, you would think that him and the captain had a special bond. I mean, they did have a pretty good relationship. They had their moments on the show, but Picard, he was really more close to Lieutenant Commander Data, who's on the show. We'll get to him in just a second. As a matter of fact, let's talk about him right now. Lieutenant Commander Data was an android on the show who pretty much knew anything and everything about anything. That's why they call him Data. And he saved the ship, the Enterprise, and everyone on it on countless occasions. I really like Lieutenant Commander Data. I mean, that's pretty much what I found The Next Generation so complex and so interesting, because the characters are completely different from the original show, and plus the new Enterprise had a few cool features that the original show did not have, like for example the holodeck. The original show didn't have that, and then the new Enterprise has something called the replicator, where you can just say, computer, I want this and I want that, and then it just comes out of thin air. Doesn't matter what it is. It could be food, it could be drinks, it could be clothing and weapons, anything. I mean, can you imagine if we really had shit like that? You know, but they both had the transporters, you know, that'll never change. And then we had Deanna Troi, who was Commander Will Riker's. She was crazy about him. You know, when she was on the show, she had on a really, really ugly uniform. I'm sorry to say that, but it was ugly as hell. But then later on, they put her on, you know, regular uniforms just like everybody else on the show. But in the beginning, she had on this, like, really skimpy pajama-like shirt and, like, really slouchy sweatpants. I mean, it was just ugly. And then they put her in this fly miniskirt. I mean, she looked hot as hell like that, but in my opinion, she was a little bony. I like them thick. And, but anyway, Captain Picard confided in her pretty much. Well, she pretty much, everyone went to her whenever they had problems and shit, but for the most part, she knew more about Captain Picard than anything else other than Will Riker, you know. And then we had Geordi LaForge, who was the chief engineer of the Enterprise, but he didn't start out that way. He started out being a helmsman of the ship. He and Lieutenant Commander Data, they were pretty much best friends on the show. They had a lot of things together, you know. And I like Geordi. You know, he had on these really cool shades and shit, you know what I'm saying? Because he was born blind, he couldn't see. So he had on these really cool looking shades and shit. And then we had Dr. Beverly Crusher, who was Captain Picard's on and off boyfriend, I guess you could say. Even though they both had several love interests throughout the show. But she was played by Gates McFadden. And Joanna LaForge was played by LeVar Burton. And Lieutenant Commander Data was played by shit, I forgot what his name is, but you know what I'm talking about. As far as Dr. Crusher is concerned, in my personal opinion, she was a terrible actress. What a lot of people don't know is that she was not the first choice on the show. There was another woman by the name of Dr. Plasky, and in my opinion, she was a far, far better actress. But the fans did not like her that much. They didn't like her at all, to be honest. The fans did not like Dr. Pulaski because she was really loud, kind of outspoken. She was not... Oh my god, that's the airplane. I apologize for that. But she was really loud, outspoken. She wasn't afraid to speak her mind. She was definitely not afraid of the captain. Whenever the captain was trying to tell her something, she always tried to... for the airplane. She always tried to loud talk him and shit, and always defied his orders, regardless what they were. She didn't take no shit from nobody, you know. And the fans just didn't like her. I loved her. You know, I thought she was a brilliant actress, and she was the kind of take charge of any and every situation. I really liked her. But the fans didn't, so you know, it's either lose fans or replace Dr. Pulaski. Now, I really don't know if they actually replaced her or she just quit the show. But she got replaced with Gates McFadden, who played Dr. Beverly Crusher. I didn't like her. I mean, she was a terrible actress and shit. But rumors were that they was looking for someone who was a lot younger and quote-unquote a lot more attractive, because I'm sorry, she was ugly to me, but I mean, I'm not trying to be mean and nothing like that, but in my personal opinion, she was just ugly, you know. But and Dr. Pulaski was an older woman, you know. You're not gonna find a picture of Dr. Pulaski above your bedroom poster shit like that. And then we had Wesley Crusher was the son of Beverly Crusher. Wesley Crusher, I mean, he was just like a 13, 14 year old kid who was incredibly smart throughout his years, beyond his years. He knew everything about the ship's operations. He knew all about the protocols. He even knew how to fly the damn thing, you know. Even though Captain Picard made it perfectly clear that he did not like children, but I guess, you know, in Wesley's case, since he was a child prodigy, and plus he benefited to the bridge. But in the beginning, it was okay. But Wesley Crusher got very, very annoying, and the reason why I say that was because you got all these grown people aboard the Enterprise. Not to mention you have an android who knew everything in existence. But you have a 12, 13 year old kid that not only saved the ship, but saved everyone on it. Almost every single episode, after episode, after episode, over and over and over again. And, you know, let's be realistic, that kind of got it, like, really boring and annoying, and the fans, they took notice of that, and Wesley had to go, and they written him off by, they had some type of episode where he no longer wanted to join Starfleet Academy, and instead he wanted to be like some drifter or some time traveler, some shit. actors on the show. He was a Klingon, and he was the only Klingon aboard the Enterprise, and he was no nonsense, didn't take no shit from nobody. He was incredibly loyal, but at the same time, he lived for combat. He was fearless, proud, you know. Now, at first, he was not ship security. That particular assignment was Lieutenant Yar. She was the chief security. Let's talk about Yar for a second. Lieutenant Commander Yar. Let's talk about her. What was so ironic about Lieutenant Commander Yar was that she quit the show. And the reason why she quit the show was because, number one, she didn't believe in the show. She said in an interview that she actually believed that Star Trek The Next Generation wouldn't last one season. That's what she said in a really old interview, like a week or so after she quit the show. She said that she didn't like the writing, she didn't like the script that they had for her. And she technically just didn't believe in the show. So she thought before the show got canceled, she just head on out and try to do bigger and better things. Boy, did she screw up. Because that one season that she thought it wouldn't make it through, it lasted 7 seasons. And the show itself produced not one, not two, not three, but 4 major featured films. And there is no doubt in my mind that had she known that the show was going to be incredibly successful as it was, there's no way she would have left the show. Boy, I bet she feels incredibly stupid right now, to be honest with you, because since she left the show, she hasn't done shit. Not anything attention worthy anyway. I don't think she's doing anything right now. Had she would have stayed with the show, it probably would have opened bigger and better opportunities for her as far as landing big roles and stuff like that. Maybe she could have had a leading role somewhere one day in a particular television show, or maybe even in a featured film. But I mean, how many times have we seen this? We've seen actors and actresses, they always leave the best thing that could possibly happen to them because they get too big for their britches, and then they feel that they are beyond that, they are better than that, and they go off and try to do bigger and better things, and they always wind up with egg on their faces. I bet you $100 right now, there's absolutely no way on God's green earth will she ever admit that she screwed up. You know, she may want to play it off and shit like that, but she'll never admit that she fucked up. Excuse my language. But anyway, it's time for me to get out of here. I got some stuff I gotta do. Y'all take care and God bless. Thank you for supporting my channel, watching my videos, and I will see you all at the comment section. Take care of each other. We have an inauguration coming up, and that's gonna be wild. That's gonna be crazy. Haven't we witnessed a lot of too much craziness already? But anyway, besides that, you guys take care and God bless. Take care of each other. Thank you guys for watching. I really do appreciate it. Thanks for supporting my channel. Thanks for commenting and all that good stuff. You guys take care and God bless. Wear a mask, wash your hands, practice that social distancing.